Thank you. ceremony for next week, because Canon Alti and I are both away for the annual chapter of the City of Christ the King in Italy, in our seminary, our mother house. So there will be no mass every day until Saturday. And this afternoon there is also no vespers and no adoration. Just the rosary will be saying our delighted seminarian will stay here to keep the house safe. And every day the rosary will be said in place of the adoration at 6 p.m. by the seminary. I think you will be very happy to see you to pray the rosary, especially in this week, very important for the institute. So the chapter is this annual meeting of all the priests of the institute, who are now around 100 priests in 25 years of existence. And those 100 priests are meeting each other in this special reunion, and that's very important. And one other thing which is very important is see during the chapter we know where we are going the week, the year which is arriving. We know if we are changing or not. And at the back of the church you can find some small boxes for your spare money. You know, there is a sentence in France who say the little river make big river. So every little help is very helpful for us. And if you want to give us your spare money, you're very welcome. Very happy to help you. Less weight in your handbag. Anything else? Oh. The name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Ghost. Amen. The Gospel of today about the resurrection of the Son of the widow of Nain is very well known by each. It's one of the three resurrection that the Gospel told us about. St. John, at the end of his Gospel, saying there is so many things and that the Lord did and said, but it should be too important to be written in a book that it's only kept by the tradition, the oral tradition. So we have only three resurrections. But how many we have? Really? The Lord, throughout the Gospel, saying there was a resurrected, he risen, three men in a visible way, but how many invisible? How many resurrections did he make? We cannot know. But every action of the Lord has a signification. If the Gospels told us about those three resurrections, the resurrection of the Son, the widow of Nain, the resurrection of Lazarus, and the resurrection of the daughter of Jair, but the three. We have to understand them in a spiritual way. St. Augustine, in the commentary of the Gospel, this Gospel we read in the breviary at Vatican this morning, St. Augustine says there is two different ways to read this minor miracle. First of all, it's like a person who don't know how to read, but he saw a beautiful letter by an picture it took, St. Augustine took, when we are having any printer. So the gospel have to write patiently and beautifully by the monks. And they take the time to make beautiful things because it was the word of God they were writing. And a man who cannot read, who cannot understand what is written, just look at the beautiful letters and he admire the work of the monk. He admire the letters which are saying the word of God, but he cannot read them. For a person who cannot read, he admire the letter and what that means. That's the same thing for the gospel. The first way to read his gospel is to admire the action of the Lord, who resurrects, who rises this poor son. The second way, the Christian way, is to see what the Lord means by this, throughout this resurrection. Throughout this resurrection, it's not only a miracle, it's an example for us. The dead body of this son is the soul of the sinner, dead by the mortal sin. And the resurrection is the pardon that he received with the confession, with the sacrament of penance. And the crowd all around is admiring the resurrection. Is the church. Is there is two parts of this cross. The first part is the church, the second part is the pagan. The pagan are just admiring a wonderful conversion, a great change of mind from this person who has a mortal sin, and when he receives the grace, he transforms his life and is now an example. But the church is admiring and glorifying God because a sinner found the right way of heaven and he renewed the grace of his baptism. That's a true way we can understand a miracle. There's all the actions of the Lord have a signification. And those both ways are the only way you can understand them, as a pagan or as a Christian. And I wish you, I'm sure you will understand them in a Christian way. Because if not, that's a problem. And we can also have a look with this gospel and the epistle. The epistle of St. Paul to the Galatians. Saying we cannot glorify of our own actions. And if we serve anybody, take some glory from his own action, is partaking in any fault. You who are the spiritual instructor, search one in the spirit of meekness, considering thyself as I have, lest thou art also be tempted. If we show that a man is taking glory or making any fault, we can kindly, softly say you are in the wrong way. That's the further correction. understand also in a spiritual way. Well, sorry, I also. So our Lord makes his resurrection not only to manifest he was God, but also was a person of grace. He gave to this man a new chance to go to heaven. So when we are going to confession, the Lord throughout the ministry of the church, the ministry of the priest is giving you a new chance for your conversion. He is giving you a new chance to go to heaven, to find a new direction in a spiritual way, in a Christian way for your life. That's the purpose of the confession. That's what we need. And that's the reason why what the priests say after your confession, in order to give you some advice, to correct you, are very important. They are not the most important part of the confession. But they are there to help you. And it's not just a quick speech in order to manifest, but it's an advice that the church, throughout the voice of the priest, give you, in order you can have now a new way of conversion, a new way of Christian life. Well, and to finish, I will wish you that you can pray as you are certainly doing now. You can pray the Blessed Virgin Mary for that, because she is our perfect mother here on earth. She was perfect on earth. She is with the soul and body in heaven. And God placed her in heaven as our best intercessor. Everything we can ask to the Blessed Virgin Mary, she will ask for us, to his beloved Son. And as she is perfect, his Son cannot refuse any graces to his mother. So ask God the graces you need for your conversion, for your Christian life, to the Blessed Virgin Mary. Amen. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Ghost.
Stand on our heart, we will be prepared. Amen. Thank you.